What's up, YouTube? Scottish Beer here again. I just went ahead and got these all screwed, well, glued and screwed. And we have our Crayola air dry clay. I'm not sure if this is gonna work yet, but it should stick in the gaps pretty well. But if you open it up, it comes in a 25-pound package. I got this from Walmart, and I had to get it online, but it's from Walmart, and it comes in these little blocks here, and I haven't even touched it in like 3 or 4 months, and you can see it's still quite soft to the touch. And it's great that it comes in 4 different packages, because I think I'll end up using maybe 1.5 to 2, depending on what it takes to get this out. But I wanted to show you guys what it looks like in the car. I have both the seats out. See if I can climb in here without busting my ass. Oop. There we go. So I get this to sit up here. It's basically going to sit like this on either side. And I'll end up fiberglassing it. And then I may or may not go crazy and try to mold it in. Try to give it some beveled edges like along the corner here, but it's pretty tight. But this is what it's gonna look like, and the ports will be in there. It should give us a tuning of 35 hertz, around 35 hertz. That should be pretty straight, but I have to put the Crayola on it right now and carve that out and try to make it look smooth. And then once that dries, I'll put the ports in, and I'll be able to just screw them in and then just make a little transition from the Crayola to the PVC, and then I'll use some fiberglass to put it all together. But if it doesn't work, I have another idea that my buddy L-Box came up with. Not only could I end up extending the ports by cutting some longer ones, but I could also square this off. Here, let me put this in my lap. I could go ahead and square this piece off, and then I could just make a port out of that. So it's always an idea. And I have a little bit of scrap wood left over right there. So we'll see what happens. See if we have any noticeable port turbulence or anything like that. But I'm gonna go ahead and get this started, and stay tuned for part 2. Alright, what's up, YouTube? I wanted to make another part to this video, but one other part in addition to this, but it's gonna take a while for this to dry. It may take more than a day, and I may have to put the spurs to it as far as heat goes, but you can see what we're... Every time I make a video, I get an email. What we're going to end up doing is smoothing this out, maybe adding just a little bit more to make a nice smooth surface, but you can see what we're after so far. It doesn't look too bad. I'm not very good with modeling clay, as you can see, but I'm alright with it. What I ended up doing was packing it all along the corners here, and then just building it out, and it looks pretty nice so far. I can't really put a piece of or put the PVC on there and do it at the same time, but they're actually quite heavy. They're heavier than they were before. I would imagine they're like 7-8 pounds, something like that. But there we go. Get an idea of what they're supposed to look like. Something like that. As you can see, it's going to give it a nice tapered edge. And as I mentioned before, I may or may not completely fiberglass it so I can do longer ports if I need to. But I think this ought to work. But yeah, that's the way it looks right now. So I should have some more for you tomorrow. Hopefully this stuff is dry by then. I'm not a big expert on modeling clay, so I couldn't tell you. But I can tell you that I'm going to be using hurricane nuts and Allen wrench or Allen head bolts to attach this. And I'll probably, like 4 points here, one of those 2 places. And then we'll put it in the wall, and I'll go ahead and cut that tomorrow after I fiberglass it. So, yeah. That's it. So until then, this is Scottish Bear signing out. Peace.